Good morning to all the children. Beta, we are doing this chapter, The Happy Prince, and hopefully we will be able to finish this also. So before I start, you can see I have added new characters. Fine, in blue color and already done character in white color. So that it little magical we have done though. Fine, so these are the new characters which we are going to read from page 33 onwards. Their entry will be there. Fine, before starting, anyone can tell me the various themes of this chapter? Continuously for 2 days, I kept on discussing that. Any of the theme you remember, beta? I'm asking him. Joy of giving is right, but yes. You haven't heard correctly. Kindness. Joy of giving, yes. Sympathy, empathy, social injustice. Fine. So, yes, use your power judiciously to help others. Fine. So, various themes are there of this chapter. Social injustice is the main highlight of this chapter. Social inequality. And then, be generous towards others. Sharing is caring. Joy of giving. Have empathy and sympathy for others. Fine. So, always ready to help the poor and needy. These are the other sub-themes of this chapter, The Happy Prince. Clear? Now, these characters, mayor and town councillors. Mayor and town councillors of that place where the statue is erected. Fine, now we have read so far when Swallow Bird wanted to go away in the beginning, but how he kept on helping the Happy Prince, that statue, and finally, he decided when that statue lost both his eyes, he donated both sapphires from his eyes to needy people. Then a Swallow Bird was having empathy for this statue. He thought, if I will fly away to Egypt, what will happen to this blind statue? Who will tell him what is going on in his city? So he decided to stay with him. Every day that Swallow Bird used to sit at the shoulder of that Happy Prince statue, and he would tell him, narrate him the stories. And you remember, his whole body is gilded with gold. Fine, he has donated his ruby from the sword, sapphires from the eyes. Fine, but after that, what is left with him? Gold. So many golden leaves are pasted on his or gilded on his statue. So leaf by leaf, he is going to help many poor people of his city. Fine. And who will be helping him? Who will be telling him about this? Swallow Bird. Fine. That Swallow Bird is going to tell the real condition of the people. He will be telling that there are two boys who want to eat something. Fine. And there are some children or the people who need gold. So in that way, Swallow Bird is going to play a very important role. And he will be plucking those golden leaves and distributing to needy people. Fine. So let's continue from page 33 onwards. We are going to read from here, Dear Little Swallow. Fine, I have highlighted here. Yes, page number 33. Dear Little Swallow, said the prince, you tell me of marvelous things, but more marvelous than anything is the suffering of men and women. There is no mystery so great as misery. Fly over my city, little swallow, and tell me, what do you see there? So, Happy Prince gave this responsibility of watching over the city, flying over the city, and tell the sufferings and miseries of people so that he can help them accordingly. So the swallow flew over the great city and saw the rich making merry in their beautiful houses while the beggars were sitting at the gates. He flew into the dark lanes and saw that white faces of starving children, starving means a bhook se mar rahe hain, looking out listlessly at the black streets. So on one side, rich people were merry making, enjoying, eating, dancing in their houses without being noticing down about the condition of beggars and poor children or poor people outside. So this is reality of our society which they have depicted. Under the archway of a bridge, two little boys were lying in each other's arms to try and keep themselves warm. How hungry we are, they said. You must not lie here, shouted the watchman, and they wandered out into the rain. See, this is the reality. Two boys, they were beggars, they were not having any home. When they found a shelter, watchman came and asked them to leave immediately. It was raining, they got drenched, they were hungry, bare feet, fine, tattered clothes. So that was the condition of those boys. So this swallow bird was eyewitnessing everything. Then he flew back and told the prince what he had seen. I am covered with fine gold, said the prince. You must take it off leaf by leaf and give it to the poor, the living. Always think that gold can make them happy. Leaf after leaf of the fine gold, the swallow picked off till the happy prince looked quite dull and gray. Leaf after leaf of the fine gold, he brought to the poor. And the children's faces grew rosier. So we are on next page now. So everyone started becoming happy. Why cheeks become rosier? When you're getting proper food, only then you can be happy and your cheeks can grow rosier. So everybody started getting gold leaves. They started getting proper money and proper food and everyone became happy in this city. Then the snow came. It was already cold in that city. And when it started snowing, it became quite frosting. The streets looked as if they were made of silver. Everybody went about in furs and little boys wore scarlet caps and skated on the ice. So everybody tried to warm themselves. They were wearing warm dresses. Fur. Fur is one of the warmest clothes, fine? So people were wearing jackets. They enjoying skating on the ice. But this ice was not good for one person. That is swallow bird. Clear? So what happened? The poor little swallow grew colder and colder. That is why he wanted to shift to Egypt, which is comparatively warmer place in that weather. So what happened to swallow? He would not leave the prince, even in that, you can say chilly winds and icy cold snowy flakes. He loved him too much. He picked up crumbs outside the baker's door when the baker was not looking and tried to keep himself warm by flapping his wings. So this was the way of survival. He was helping others and he was trying to warm himself with the help of his wings only. He did not have any other option. But at last he knew that he was going to die. He had just enough strength to fly up to the prince's shoulder once more. He was not able to fly even. Only one effort was left. He knew that he could fly just above the shoulder of this prince. And goodbye, dear prince, he murmured, because he was not able to speak even. Girls, beta, you can use that space. Again, you're sitting like this. And Brijesh, ab last pe shift ho jao. Okay, fine. Bench piche kar lo apna. Apna bench piche kar lo. Pushti. आशना वो बेंच गंदा है लास्ट वाला हाँ पुष्टि यू कैन सिट देयर सेकंड डेस्क फाइन जितना आपका कवर हो सकता है डिस्टेंस ट्राई टू स्कैटर फाइन सो बट एट लास्ट ही न्यू दैट ही वाज गोइंग टू डाई ही हैड जस्ट इनफ स्ट्रेंथ टू फ्लाई अप टू प्रिंसेस शोल्डर विल यू लेट मी किस योर हैंड दिस बर्ड आस्क्ड दिस स्टैचू आई एम ग्लैड दैट यू आर गोइंग टू इजिप्ट एट लास्ट लिटिल स्वान But statue ko kya laga? Happy prince thought because this is the last time he wants to touch me and he wants to kiss me because he's going to Egypt. But this was not the reality. He was going to die. I'm glad that you are going to Egypt, little swallow, said the prince. You have stayed too long here, but you must kiss me on lips for I love you. So it is not to Egypt. That I am going, said the swallow. I am going to the house of death. Death is the brother of sleep, is he not? And he kissed the happy prince on the lips and fell down dead at his feet. So that was the end of Swallow Bird. After doing many good deeds, helping many people, playing the role of assistant to Happy Prince, and also became his eyes, you can say. At that moment, a curious crack sounded inside the statue as if something had broken. Loud noise. The moment that bird died, a loud noise was heard. And what was that noise? That was the heart of that statue broke into pieces. His heart was made up of lead, but it was so attached to that bird that it got broken even the death after the death of this bird. It certainly was a dreadfully hard frost. Early the next morning, the mayor was walking in the square below in company with the town council. So this is the entry of new characters. You know that who are councillors of the districts and cities and mayors, they have responsibility to make it greener, cleaner, and benefits of people, fine? Then what happened? They were going, and as they passed the column, they looked at the statue. And mayor said, "Dear me, how shabby the happy prince looks." And the councillors, they were just like blind followers of mayor. Whatever mayor spoke, usi words ko as it is bolte the. They said, how shabby indeed, cried the town councillors, who always agreed with the mayor, and they went up to look at it. "The ruby has fallen out of the sword," mayor said. "His eyes are gone and he's no longer golden. In fact, he's little better than a beggar." Ye to beggar se thoda sa better lag raha hai, but he's equivalent to beggar only. "What is the condition of the statue?" And town councillor said, "Yes, little better than a beggar. And here is actually a dead bird at his feet," continued the mayor. "Keta, see, a bird is dead in his feet. We must really issue a proclamation." Proclamation is announcement that birds are not to be allowed to die here. Do you believe that this proclamation is valid? If somebody has to die, that person will die at any place. So it shows that mayor and councillors both are not at all wise people. Clear? Is statement se ye pata lagta hai. So he says, and town clerk made a note of the suggestion. Clerk was standing there and he noted down whatever mayor said. So what did they do? They pulled down the statue of Happy Prince, as he is no longer beautiful, no longer useful. And they gave it to one art professor at one university. So what did that art professor do? That is another character in this story. Art character. He melted the statue in a furnace. Furnace is a fireplace where all the things are melted. So he thought, that art professor thought, the statue is no longer for any use. Let's melt it. "What a strange thing," said the overseer of the workmen at the foundry. So when his statue was being melted, one of the workmen was standing there. "This broken lead heart will not melt in the furnace." Sara kuch melt ho gaya. But only one thing could not be melted. That was heart of that statue. So they threw it on a dust heap where the dead swallow was also lying. Unke liye to koi useful nahi tha wo. So they thought, what is this piece of lead? But actually it was heart of Happy Prince. So they threw the heart of Happy Prince on a dust of heap. Ek dher tha mitti ka. They threw it over there. And in the same heap, dead body of that swallow bird was lying. It means even after the death, that heart of the prince and swallow bird were together. That was the end of the story. Now you can see, there are last lines. "Bring me the two most precious things." This thing is about, it happened in heaven. It is in the place where God resides. So God is, you know, asking one of his angels. This is believed only. This is a fictional story, but this is part of it. God was sitting one day and God asked one of his angels, that bring me the two most precious things in the city. इस सिटी की सबसे प्रीशियस थिंग्स लेके आओ. गो प्रीशियस मीन्स वेरी कॉस्टली. एंड दैट एंजल ब्रॉट हिम द लेडन हार्ट एंड द डेड बर्ड. सो दैट एंजल वॉज एबल टू परसीव दैट दीज टू थिंग्स आर द मोस्ट प्रीशियस थिंग्स इन द सिटी. बाकी सब चीजें यूजलेस है. यू हैव राइटली चोजन सेड गॉड फॉर इन माई गार्डन ऑफ पैराडाइज. पैराडाइज मीन्स हेवन. This little bird shall sing forever more, and in my city of gold, the happy prince shall praise me. It means after the death, God called both of them to their place because they were very good-hearted fellows. So the story ended. How do you like it? Yes, beta, are you able to? There is some connection problem. Did you listen to the whole story? Send me thumbs up if my voice is approaching you all. Yes, beta, awaaz aa rahi hai sabko? Okay. Fine. Now we'll be doing question answers. Theme we have discussed, stories beautiful we have read. Fine. Three words are written beta on page 36. Seamstress is a woman who makes a living by sewing. Thimble is a metal or plastic cap with a closed end, worn to protect the finger. ये finger पे डालते हैं thimble को and it is used to push the needle. Garret is a small room where who was sitting in the garret? Playwright was sitting in the garret. Fine. So let's start with question answers. You will be raising your hands, children sitting in the class as well as sitting at home. Why do the courtiers call the prince the happy prince? Is he really happy? What does he see all around him? Three parts are there. Yes, Navya, kindly stand up. You tell me, why do the courtiers call the prince happy prince? Because? No, it is in the beginning of the chapter. Yes, Jaydev. Yes, this is the answer, fine. So don't get confused. Yes, very good, sit down. So let me, Jaydev has given correct answer. Why do the courtiers call the prince?